The Math Center presents Combinations. In this presentation, we'll talk about the definition of a combination, give examples of combinations, and finally discuss the difference between permutations and combinations. The combination formula tells us how many unordered arrangements we can make if we pick a certain number of items from a larger group of items. The important part to remember is that order does not matter. Some examples would be, suppose we select three finalists in a cooking contest from a group of 12 people. The three finalists will all go to the final round, so it doesn't matter if they were chosen first or last. Another example would be when you're playing cards. You're dealt five cards. Once the cards are in your hand, you can move them around. The order didn't matter. Another common example is picking six numbers from 49 on a lottery ticket. Whether you pick a number first or last, it doesn't matter. Here is the formula we use to find the number of possible combinations. In this formula, we are choosing R items from a larger group of N items. The formula is a fraction. On top is N with an exclamation point after it, which in math means N factorial. This is a shorthand way of taking all the whole numbers from 1 to N and multiplying them together. For instance, 5 factorial equals 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So on top we have N factorial, and on the bottom we have N minus R factorial times R factorial. Let's look at an example to see how we would use this formula. Say you go to a bookstore and find 20 books you want, but you can only afford to buy 5 of them. How many ways could you select 5 books from a group of 20? In this case, order doesn't matter. Whether the cashier rings up Moby Dick first or last, you still have the same 5 books when you get home. So in this problem, we're picking 5 books from a group of 20. So R equals 5 and N equals 20. The first thing we do is rewrite the formula with R equal to 5 and N equal to 20. This gives us 20 factorial on the top, and that is divided by 20 minus 5 factorial, multiplied by 5 factorial. Following the order of operations, we do what is in parentheses first and subtract 5 from 20. So now on the bottom we have 15 factorial times 5 factorial. The next step is to reduce things a bit to make it easier. On the top we have 20 factorial, and on the bottom there is a 15 factorial. It would be great if we could simplify those two, and it turns out we can. We can rewrite 20 factorial as 20 times 19 times 18 times 17 times 16, and we could keep going all the way to 1. But all the numbers from 15 to 1 multiplied together is 15 factorial. So I'll stop with 16 and then tack on a 15 factorial. Now we have 15 factorial on top and 15 factorial on the bottom, so we can cancel them. This leaves 20 times 19 times 18 times 17 times 16 on the top and 5 factorial on the bottom. Now we can do the multiplication on the top and bottom, and finally divide to get an answer of 15,504. Looking at the last example, you can see there were a lot of computations involved in finding a combination. So let's talk about how to make things easier by using a calculator. Most scientific calculators have a combination key. Usually you would enter the value for N first, then hit the NCR key, and then put in the R value, and finally hit the equal key. The calculator I have here is from Desmos.com. You click function, then click on the NCR key, and it comes up with parentheses. You just have to enter 20, 5, and your answer is listed off to the right. Another great way to calculate combinations is using Microsoft Excel. There's a function, Combin, that you use. First, open a new spreadsheet and click on any empty cell. Then use the function bar at the top and always start by typing an equal sign. Then type in those 6 letters, C-O-M-B-I-N. Open up some parentheses, then put the value for N in first, followed by a comma, and then the value of R. Then type in a close parenthesis and click Enter. The value of the combination function should be in the cell. What is the difference between permutations and combinations? They are similar, but the key difference is whether you care about the order of the selection or not. Permutations are used when you're selecting ordered arrangements. Think of the medals in the Olympics. There are 3 medalists, but the order does matter. The first place athlete wins gold, while the third place wins bronze. You would use combinations when the order of the selection doesn't matter. Because of the difference, the number of combinations is always less than the number of permutations. Thank you for watching this presentation on combinations.